So why is it that the narcissist discards are so inhumanly cruel, it seems? The easiest way to explain the answer to this is that it is remarkably cruel when you are discarded by a narcissist, and there is nothing nice or civil about being discarded whatsoever. The added bonus on top of all of that hurt and pain that you're feeling is the unanswered question and the continued unanswered question of why. And because there is no real answer to that, I cannot give you an answer to help you feel better other than these facts that are following. It seems cruel because it is. They go out of their way to hurt you, especially at the discard, which is one of your most vulnerable states and at this phase in the relationship with the narcissist. The reason why it seems so cruel and so hurtful, because at about this time in the relationship is when you are supposed to see the real person or finally become comfortable with the person that you are in a relationship with and let your guard down in a healthy way. But in this case, it becomes so unhealthy and so toxic because the narcissist finally feels comfortable enough to drop that mask, and they show us a person that is so shocking and surprising because of how few and far between their genuine emotional reactions truly are and were going back thinking about it. This is who the narcissist truly, truly is. During the discard, you can see exactly who it is that this person really truly is, regardless of how much you care about them. They go out of their way to hurt you, and they hurt you because that is what narcissists do, and that is who they truly are. The honest and no holds bar truth is that it is cruel in reality that a person did not give one single shit about you to begin with. During the discard, it may be one of the very first times that you see the shocking reality of what lies underneath the narcissist mask. This is the first time that they are actually showing you exactly who they are and what and whom they care about. They don't care about anybody but themselves. They are not worried about you at all. They are worried about their next supply that they have lined up while they are still trying to remove you from their life so that you don't get in the way of that love bombing and golden period between the new supply and the narcissist. And they are thinking about what angle they need to take upon meeting with their new supply, and you are falling apart at the seams at home, and the narcissist could care less. He is more worried about that new supply, and how could he even be thinking about that such extremely mundane things? And even that has more meaning and importance than the fact that the life with your person, with your significant other, was a total and complete sham. None of that stuff means anything to a narcissist at all, especially in the discard period and, well, in every phase of the relationship, including the honeymoon phase or the golden period. In the long run, you will be thankful that the narcissist discarded you. Because the longer you are with one, the more time that you are going to need to recover. And if you spend time trying to understand how somebody could treat you as poorly as the narcissist has, and that you are no one to them and that you didn't matter at all, you are just going to drive yourself crazy and possibly show all of the narcissists friends and family that they have smeared you to, that you are, in fact, this mentally unhinged person who has lost their mind. And that's exactly what they want. Sometimes for a narcissist, a breakup can be known as a faux breakup. It means that their batteries are fully recharged after a long period of peace, love, support, and healthy mindfulness, plus loads and loads of unconditional, undying love from you, the old source of supply. When they feel that their broken souls are fully nurtured, you become boring to them and they are ready to go and experience the fullness of life, which they are not capable of experiencing. And that safety that was stemming from your wholeness is not appealing to the narcissist anymore, and they start to resent you for being whole and happy when you shouldn't be. You don't deserve to be happy because you've made mistakes in the past, and now you're living your best life with full confidence while you should be living with a guilty conscience constantly, just as the narcissist does. The discard or the escape or the breakup, whatever, from a narcissist is a huge opportunity to unleash all of the pent-up rage they were keeping quiet to themselves as they were feeding off of your wholeness. More fundamentally, you will decipher their breakup language as the full epitome of what someone or most people would call a childhood rage or a three-year-old's fit. They have this childhood rage circumscribed and imprisoned within their very hearts. And when they feel that you are on the verge of escaping them, on the other hand, instead of the discard, they will make sure that they severely attack you and wound your soul where it hurts the most. Not to mention, they are perfectly aware of what it takes for you to leave them. Even if you do leave them and no contact, they will know that you are dying for them to contact you, at least in the beginning of the aftermath of the breakup. If you do it the healthy way and go no contact as soon as you're discarded or you escape, then these feelings will eventually subside. The reasons that narcissists want to mentally and physically harm people have nothing to do with us. They want us to feel broken inside, just like they do. For them, it's not fair that you get to be a whole and happy person. Why? Simply because the narcissist was always told to suppress his or her emotions, suck things up, and was severely mentally abused as a child. And a lot of male narcissists were told to man up and that men don't have emotions and men don't cry, and to conform to this logic. Brokenness has become the narcissist's number one standard and number one direction in life. After this discard, escape, however it is that you became separated and free from the narcissist, take advantage of that and take your freedom back by going no contact. Remember the vacations that were ruined when things didn't live up to their expectations. Remember the daily lies about nothing and everything, things that didn't even matter, but did they? Remember all of the weirdness with female friends and all of the times that they treated you like you didn't matter. Remember all of the times that they turned their guilt into your feelings. Remember how they treated you like a rival. Remember how you constantly had to defend their arrogant ways to your family and friends. Remember how you had to run interference between him and everyone else, how he or she made everyone tiptoe around them so that they don't get pissed off again and again and again. Remember how they complained about never going out, but you were the one who planned every vacation, every concert, every play, whatever it is that you were into, except for the places that they went to by themselves and didn't invite you to, which you most likely have no idea about. Remember how that narcissist walked out the door and didn't even look back once. Remember how you had forgiven them months later without a semblance of an apology and have made every effort in the world to fix this relationship? And remember how they used you for information on how to be a better person? Remember how they stole your character traits? Remember how they passed off things that you had accomplished as their own? Remember self-talk and don't forget what is real. Walk away and stop taking those phone calls and those text messages. Eventually, you will stop thinking about that narcissist. And it may not be right now, it may not be 6 months or a year down the road, but one day you will wake up and not think about that narcissist. And the next day will be like,